Hey you guys, this is going to be kind of like a bit of an update. I'm also going to share with you guys a few things that I've been buying and some cards I've been making, some digital stamps that I have designed. It's gonna be a little bit of everything. So I have been getting quite a few messages from some of you guys just wondering why I haven't been as active on my channel and also on my Facebook. I just wanted to address that on a video instead of just responding to the messages individually. So I have been on a holiday at the end of the year last year. I went to visit family, so I was away for the end of the year and also the beginning of this year. I still had some videos going live for part of that period just because I was able to edit those videos and upload it to my YouTube channel and then schedule those videos to go live on certain dates. So you guys probably have seen that I had some activity back then at the end of the year. Unfortunately, at the beginning of the year, I kind of ran out of those videos. I still have a ton of videos that I have filmed last year that I haven't got the chance to edit yet. So some of those are going to be coming up very soon. As soon as I get the chance to edit them, I will do so and upload them. There might be some Christmas videos and then a whole bunch of variety of videos, like there's techniques, tutorials and all sorts, so just watch out for those. The reason I haven't been as active lately is because I've got some news. I'm actually pregnant. I am well into my second trimester. I haven't actually been feeling very well lately. I haven't been up to crafting so much. I was actually told that I should have been feeling better by now, but I guess some women just don't. So yeah, as soon as I feel up to doing some editing and making some videos, I will do that and post them as and when I can. So I really hope you guys understand and stick with me because I will try my best to be as active as possible on here. So yeah, that is my bit of news that I wanted to share with you guys. The only things I have actually been making lately were a few cards. I have actually got a couple of projects to share with you guys. One is for Lavish Laces, the other one is for Witchcraft. So I'll have those videos up very soon, so watch out for those. I also have a product review coming soon, so if you're interested in that, just keep an eye out for that. And I'll share the cards that I've been making with you guys a little bit later. I thought I would share some of my purchases with you guys, and actually I haven't been buying a whole lot of crafty goodies at the moment because of course we're buying a lot of baby stuff right now. As is our first child, I just didn't realize how much there is to purchase. So yeah, it doesn't leave me much budget for crafty goodies. But I do have a lot of supplies, so I'll probably try and use those. So anyways, I thought I would share with you guys a couple of things that I brought back from my holiday, and I didn't bring a lot back. So the first thing I have here is this desk organizer, and it's actually really sturdy, thick wood, so I thought I would bring this back to alter. I also bought this, which is a book holder. I think it goes on like this, yeah. So it kind of sits on your shelf a little bit like this, and you put it in your kitchen and you just place your book on there for following the recipe or something like that. So I thought that that was a really pretty piece and I wanted to alter that. So I brought that back too, and again, really thick, sturdy wood. And next I have a few wood pieces here. I've got this little Eiffel Tower shape, and it's laser cut as well, and of course you guys know I love Parisian themed things, so I got some of those. I also got some of these swirls just for adding on cards or smaller projects or anything really. I also have this little seahorse. I love seahorses. I also purchased this little Noah's Ark, and it's so adorable. It's also laser cut, and you can see kind of the burnt marks here. And this is the front, so it actually has the little engraved areas here. Actually, I was thinking a baby project with this. I also have this little, is it like a centipede, I think? I'm not sure. I just thought it was really cute, and again thinking of baby project. And I also got this little crown. Actually, this little crown is not for me. I actually purchased for someone else. It's a friend, and I know she likes crowns. And here is my next bit of purchase. So here's the first thing. These are all made of plaster and they're very, very heavy. So this is actually some feet, and you can see how gorgeous they are. So it comes in a set of four. It just looks like that. So I thought it would be really nice for a pretty box or something like that. I also bought some cherubs, and this is the first one right here. And he's so, so cute. I love cherubs. So I bought a couple. So here's another one. And this one is so heavy as well. And I thought it'd be nice for a large project. And here is the other one. Really, really cute. I also bought this large piece here, and I thought that was really, really cute. I thought it would look really nice on a box or something like that. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do with these pieces yet, so we'll have to wait and see. I also purchased this cute little frame. And again, it's very, very heavy and it's made of plaster, so it would probably break if I dropped it. I also got a couple of crowns and stuff, so there's another little cherub there. A tiny little frame, and it has some details on it as well, which is really cute. And that's just the same. And here is some swirls, another cute little frame. Here's the next piece, is this cute little cherub. Let's see, another little frame, some more swirls, and this pretty medallion kind of a piece here. And so all of these can be painted and altered, so I am really looking forward to doing something with those. So the next stuff is just pretty boring stuff, just some adhesive. I was almost out, so I got some double-sided tape in different kind of thickness here, hot glue for my glue gun, and then I also got some more of my tape runner. And I've also got another pack of Versamark because I was out. And then I got some more of this stuff, which I love. This is a little bit like glossy accent. This is clear gloss, so you just add it to give a little bit dimension and shine. So I really use a lot of this stuff, so I got some more. I also got some inks. I got these three pads right here. It's just colors that I didn't have, and these were really, really cheap, so I just got those to try. I had never tried the Dovecraft Premium Pigment ink pads, so that's why I got those. I also got a couple more of the Distress inks, some colors that I didn't have, but I've already been using them, and they're already stored away, so they're not here. And I also got another one of these little mister bottles, because I have been wanting to try some watercolor techniques for a while. So I got that. I have one already, but I got an extra one. And I've also got some Distress watercolor cardstock by Tim Holtz, and I purchased these online, and as you can see, I've already been using some, and I'll share some of those with you guys in a minute. I had not tried these before, so I really wanted to try some ideas that I had. And so yeah, that's that. I've also got some sequins. I had some sequins already, but they were colors that I didn't really like so much. So I purchased some pale pink, purple, black, blue, fuchsia, aqua green. And this one is actually a mixed bag. I don't know if you guys can see. It's iridescent, so it's almost clear. But it has some leaves, it has stars, it has tiny little circles, larger circles. So it's a whole mixture of it, which is really, really cool. Now I've got a couple of things that I got from the range, and just got some white gel pen. Mine had dried out. I had barely used it. I had one of those Ink Essential white gel pen, and I don't know what happened. It looked like I still had ink, and I was trying to get it working, and it just would not work. So I don't know if any of you guys have any tips for getting that working again. please let me know, because I even tried to kind of like heat it up. Like, I took the inside part out and I was like rolling in my hand, you know, I was trying on the piece of paper. I tried to like peel off the end because I thought it was a little bit dry there, but it just wouldn't work. So I got some more, and these are actually the Uniball Signo. It's the brand right there. I really like this one, it's really good. And these are the new stamps by Santoro, and this is the urban stamp. So a Santoro with Duke Crafts. So you guys know I love Gorgeous Girls, and I had some of these last time that they released, and now they released some new ones, and I think they have, I don't even know how many, but they had at least another 4 or 5 designs that I didn't purchase. And I got the 3 that I liked the most. And this is the first one right here. So she is called the Fox. And it's really, really cute. It's the little girl. And then you have the tiny little foxes. You have this beautiful corner stamp. And then some leaves. I also got this one, which is called Ladybird. And there is what you get. So you get the little girl, this beautiful frame, and then this border stamp. And last but not least, I've got the black star. And again, you get this beautiful frame and the bow. And there's like a little button here. And also this little stamp that says Simply Gorgeous. And I already stamped some of those and colored. So I was trying my watercolor pencils. So this is the result. I still need to practice with my watercolor pencils. I'm not all that good with it. So yeah, just a lot of practice is needed. So here is the other one. Really, really cute. I colored in some of the foxes and some of the stars, and I didn't care so much for the lines here because I am going to cut them out when I use them. Here's that one again. And here's the little fox. And this little cute little one here again. I also got this other stamp here, which is from the Urban Stamps as well, with Duke Crafts and Paper Mania. And this one is actually perfect to match with the Madame Peyroad collection. It's a new collection. I actually have the papers here. I'll share with you guys in just a moment. And this is a postcard stamp. I've been looking for a stamp like this for a long time. So now that I found it, I just had to grab it. And here's the Madame Peyroad paper. And this, I have to say, is a really, really nice paper. This is by Paper Mania Duke Crafts as well. And I'll show you guys what the papers look like. Okay, so I zoomed in so that you guys can see it a little bit better. So you get 2 sheets of each. It's gorgeous. I'll try and be quick here because this video is going to be super long already. I have to say Paper Mania have been upping their game lately. I really like this latest collection. It's really, really pretty. It actually reminds me of maybe a mixture of Graphic 45 and Prima. I don't know, maybe that's just me, but I really like the vintage feel throughout. And there's some like old advertisement style of paper here, and some typewriter kind of keys there, and I think there's a stamp that is those letters as well, but at my range they didn't have it. I saw it online actually. So yeah, this is really, really nice as well. Really like this gothic looking kind of the arches or whatever they're called here. And then a random blue paper here. Some beautiful roses and butterflies. And last but not least, this one right here. Then next, I actually wanted to show you guys this. I bought this card making and paper craft magazine. Sometimes I buy these just, I kind of collect them. And it came with this free stamp. And I just wanted to show you guys how pretty that is. Some beautiful roses there, and it also came with some free papers, so that's really cute too. I just wanted to show you guys. And I also purchased from Sainsbury's actually some washi tape, and they're really, really cute. So that's what they look like. I love the floral and the stripy one, and I really, really like the pink with the bikes. It's really adorable. Then from TK Maxx, I bought some 6x6 paper pads. So I went to have a look the other day and they had these. And so this is the Dream. And I'll just quickly flick through just in case you guys are interested in seeing what it looks like. But most of you probably already know what it looks like. I think it's an older collection. And this one is called Sunny. And and I really like the little bikes on this one. It's really kind of summery colors, which I really like. And then I also got this one, which is called Handsome. That's what they look like. And it's more masculine patterns, which I really like. And I got two because I'm sharing one of the packs. So now I just wanted to quickly show you guys what I've been playing with my watercolor papers. So I had a bit of a test run with this one, and it's really pastel light colors, and you can see I still have streak marks on that one, so I really have to practice. This next one here I embossed with a wood background stamp that I have. I just clear embossed it and then I did some coloring over it, which looks really nice actually. I quite like the effect on that. But what I really wanted to do with these watercolor papers is this. There's something really trendy right now that's called Galaxy, and I've been seeing that on everything. I've been seeing that on tops, dresses, trousers, leggings, shoes, everything. And I think it's really cool effect, and I really wanted to try and transfer that onto paper and make some cool cards with it. I have some ideas on what to do. So that's what I've done. I actually have a picture that I found online of some outfits that have this galaxy pattern. So what I'll do, I'll probably post that on my Instagram. And so if you guys want to check it out, I'll link my Instagram down below so you guys can see that. So yeah, that is my inspiration for it. I just looked at some of the outfits and the colors, and that's what I did. And I used Tim Holtz Distress ink pads for this, so it works really well. And you can see I've got some red and purple, blue, black, green going on this one. And I actually have the colors on the back if you guys are interested. So for this one here, I've used quite a few colors. I've used Spun Sugar, Worn Lipstick, Shabby Shutters, Bandled Sage, Tumble Glass, Chip Sapphire, Seedless Preserve, and Black Suit. So that is that one. This one right here is really cool. It has like more subtle blues and pinks and also the black. And I've used Sugar Spun, Worn Lipstick, Tumbled Glass, Chip Sapphire, and Black Suit. So two tones of the pink and two tones of the blue and then the black. For this one, I actually didn't have an orange color, so what I did, I mixed the red and a yellow that I have, and it created this beautiful orangey kind of a tone. So the colors that I used was Mustard Seed, which is the yellow, Barn Door, which is the red, and I mixed them together and it made this pretty orange here, and Stormy Sky, which is a blue, Chip Sapphire, also a blue, and Black Suit. So there is the effect that I got. The next one, which is really cool, I really love this one. This is, I think, my favorite. I really like this one, how it turned out. And the colors for this one are Seedless Preserve, Chipped Sapphire, and Black Suit. So I didn't use two different tones of the same color. I just used the purple, the blue, and the black. Simple as that. And that is that one. Now this one, I actually used Distress Markers. And I've got a really different effect. So you can see here. And what I also did, I used that technique where you just splash a little bit of water and then you put a tissue paper and you get some of the ink out, and you can see a little bit of the splatters. And if you're wondering about the stars and the white bits, I'm actually gonna do some embossing on these before I turn them into a card. So they're not finished. I just wanted to show you guys the technique that I've used with the inks and my trial with the watercolor paper. So that's that. Now I was gonna show you guys some cards that I've made. So here's the first one. It's just a baby card, and I designed this little elephant and also the little balloons. I actually have been designing quite a few digital stamps because I wanted to make some specific cards and I didn't have the stamp for it, so I decided to just go ahead and design my own. It's just quicker and easier for me, and also a lot cheaper because I don't have to pay for anything. I just go and design what I want and, you know, print it out in color. So that's what I did. I've got a couple of other animals which I don't have here. I actually have the one of them is this little whale here, and I actually designed a little cow, a little hippo, a giraffe, a I think that was it. But anyway, so this is the card, and I'm actually gonna cover up the inside here because I've already written this card. And I've also designed this cute little baby face here. And this is just the card that I wanted to give my husband when we had our ultrasound scan to find out the gender of our baby. And as you can tell, we're having a little girl. And the little bow on her head has that clear gloss on top, so it looks really, really cute. I actually had made a It's a Boy paper as well. This is actually a printout that I've designed, and then the little bow I actually printed down here so that I could color it whatever color I wanted. And I thought for the boy it could just become a little bow tie, since on the little girl it's a little bow on her head. So yeah, that's the first card I wanted to show you guys. The second one is this good luck card. And again, I've used that watercolor technique on the back here with the Tim Holtz paper. And I really like this. I used the distress markers for this and just made like this rainbow pattern, like on a kind of like an angle. And then I just added quite a lot of water, so it made it really pastel. Just simply place that on my card. And I've also used some of those sequins that you saw earlier. Next card is this one right here, and it's just a congratulations card. Once again, I've used some inking and watercolor technique on the background. This is once again that watercolor paper. I've just added some blue ink on the top and green on the bottom, just spritz with some water, and it looks really cute. This little camper van, I really like how it turned out, is also one of the things that I've designed recently. And I just wanted to create a congratulations card on someone passing their driving exam, so that's what I did. And I'll show you guys the whole set in just a moment that I've created. On the windows, I actually used that clear gloss again, and on the wheels as well, in the center, you can see. Also on the front light, it has a little bit, so that's what that card looks like. Very simple, but I think turned out really cute. And here's just some more of those little vans I just colored in different colors. I wasn't sure what color I was going to use, and I ended up going with the green. Next card I've got here is an Easter card, and this turned out quite cute as well. I really like it. It's just a very simple Easter card once again. I've stamped this little cheek, which is from a Paper Mania stamp. I'll show you guys some tryouts that I had here. The cheek doesn't have the glass and the hat originally, it's just the cheek, just like that. So I have some stamps that have the different little hats and also the little glasses. So you can see I was doing some stamping on there just to see what I liked better. So I put different kind of glasses and different kind of hats. And this is the one that I chose to use. So I colored the cheek in yellow, and then for the glasses I used that clear gloss once again. So as I told you guys, I do use it a lot, so and that's what it looks like. These little eggs here, I just handmade them. I inked some white paper with the different colored inks, and then I've used some holographic embossing powder, which has this little glittery kind of look. So it gives it a little bit of texture, but also the kind of glittery look, which I was after. And the background is once again distress ink and watercolor paper. And then I just did like a two-layer thing here so that it looks like the cheek is standing on the grass. Use some more of those sequins down here. This is the aqua green, and just printed Happy Easter on top. So once again, very simple card, but I think it looks really cute. Next card I have here is a good luck card, and again I've used the watercolor technique. Like I told you guys, I really wanted to try some ideas on this paper, so that's what I did. I just made a whole bunch all at once, and then I just used it on cards. So what I did, I stamped with clear embossing on the background first, this large stamp that I have that says good luck in different fonts. I just did some coloring with my distress markers, and then I spritzed with the water, and it just gave me this really cool effect, which I like. And then I used some sequins again, and then also mounted it onto a card. And now last but not least, my favorite card. This is again a congratulations on passing your driving exam card, and a lot of the things that you see here I've actually designed myself. The little car, the little out plates here, the little well done sign, the congratulations. And I'll show you guys what the stamp looks like actually. So I'll zoom out. So this is what I've designed. I designed a little car, the little camper van. I've also designed this little stamp here that just says past, and then it has 100% going around. I've got the little L plates here. I've got them in larger and then smaller sizes down here. I've also got this sentiment, you can do it, good luck, which I didn't end up using. I've got the congratulations, which is what you see on the front of the card. And then the little signs, I've designed the well done and the stop. And then also enjoy the ride. And then down here, what I did was I wanted to have little different car plates to go in the center. So I have different options. The first one actually reads past, which is the one that I've used here. And the other ones just say congrats. There's a just married one, just in case I want to use this stamp for a different kind of card. Well done, bon voyage. Happy birthday, day out and around the world. And then I also created the little box in blank because I could actually try and stamp something in there if I have a small enough stamp. But yeah, anyway, so that is what I've designed. And right here, I've used that clear gloss on the window. I've also used it on the light and then on the pass. I've used it on the well done sign right there. And so yeah, that is what the card looks like. And of course the background, can you guess? Watercolor paper, just because. And on the inside of this card, this is what it looks like. So I've used that stamp that I designed that just reads past. And I created a little pocket here because I'm actually going to include a gift voucher in here, just like a gift for the person instead of having to give a full-on gift. And then I've got the stop sign in here also with the clear gloss, and it just matches the papers from the front, and that is what that looks like. So I really hope you guys like this video. I hope it answers some of your questions. Thank you so much for your concern. I am actually getting back to making videos now. I'm making this video. I also have a couple of project videos that I need to film now and get all edited and uploaded. I also have a Happy Mail video to film, so yeah, I'm gonna be quite busy this afternoon. But thank you guys so much for sticking with me, and welcome to all my new subscribers. I think I gained just over 6,000 subscribers since I left for my holiday last year, so welcome to everybody. I really hope you find inspiration in my channel. And to all of you guys, if you have any questions, just comment below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be back very soon with some more videos. Stay tuned for that. Bye!